All right, y'all. Welcome back to the Vessel Free. That's me, honey. If you're new, love to have you. And if you're returning, thank you so much for supporting my channel. All right, this is going to be for the zodiac sign of Virgo. I have some channel messages here, so we're going to get right into it, honey. We're going to get right into it, okay? The first thing I have here is my old flex is my new flex, period. All right. So I feel like there could be a reconciliation here or a past love returning, somebody that you talked to before, dated before, was with before, whatever this is, returning back to be a new flex, okay? Period. That's what I'm getting here. And then I'll channel this song Controller by Drake. If some of you guys want to go listen to that song. I feel like somebody like that line where he's like, you like when I get aggressive. Somebody likes our like our like that. You know what I'm saying? They're like, ooh, get a little aggressive. You know what I'm saying? They like that shit. Because right next to that, I had channeled some rough sex and my hands getting mighty hot. Okay, something about your hands, you may have healing or very passionate, or just like something about your hands is like magical hands or something like that. But also, I was getting, they don't want to see me get your loving. All right, so there could be somebody you're connected to that don't want to see you get this loving, or this other person that, you know, is connected to them. Somebody don't want to see them get this loving. Whatever this is, it's a situation where somebody's trying to control somebody else's love life. Is what I'm getting here. All right, but I feel like you're getting a lot and lots of downloads at this time concerning this situation or this person. All right, and then I have here one of the blockages or one of the obstacles. Could be that you or somebody else could be used to people wanting them for money, wanting to be with them for money. So whatever this is, I don't know what it is. We just gonna get right into it and see. Do I want to start with the left? Let's see what we got here. Yes, you got a yes here. All right, so that's what's going on. But I also feel like yes to compromise and recovery. All right, so there could have been a, like I said, a past connection or something here that had to go through some type of recovery here that had to be compromised or had to be balanced. Somebody could have went within, did some meditation, spent some time with their angels, figuring out whether, you know, whatever this is or, right, we'll get into it. But you have a yes here. All right, and then with the bird above here, I feel like spirit is telling you that something is a yes, like something we're gonna give you something that you can say yes to that can be yours. All right, now I'm seeing the world card in my third eye. So I feel like something about like you transforming your identity is helping transform some type of connection here. And something is, it's like something in the past is completely over. So if there was a connection that was over, a situation that was over, it's like this reconciliation or my old flex is my new flex. It's a new flex because the old one is dead off, if that makes sense. All right. So kind of like a transformation. And then you have yes, the situation will improve. So if there is somebody trying to block something here, it's like spirit saying, yes, this is still a yes, the situation will improve, right? Kind of like keep going. All right. And then you have another yes. All right. So that's double yeses. 3, 2, 1. When I said that, angel number 3, 2, 1, and it's currently 2, 3, 4. So look up angel numbers 2, 3, 4, and 3, 2, 1. See the significance in this read. But you have yes and yes. I also feel like yes to temperance. Some of you guys could be dealing with a Sagittarius or something about this Sagittarius season. Something is gonna like, I'm holding the card. There's gonna be a new opportunity by, I feel like, Sagittarius season, specifically December for some of you guys. This seems like an energy of where two different people or energies. You have fire and Pluto. So some of you guys could be dealing with Scorpio. Others of you guys could be dealing with the fire sign, which is still Sagittarius, right? It's like spirit is guiding something together. And this picture, you have yes, giving like the universe, the planets, the galaxy is kind of what I'm getting off this card. It's like something's coming into balance, something's being modified for this opportunity to come in. It's like I'm hearing a gift of gold. Like somebody feels like they struck gold. Maybe you literally did, all right? But it's like this, whatever this is a huge opportunity. And this situation is going to help improve, I feel like, your life, improve. I'm hearing something is destined, improve your destiny or whatever this is. And then this yes is like, I feel like spirit is bringing this beautiful energy over here with the rainbow here, this beautiful energy over here, and it's making that rainbow come together. 444, as soon as I said that. And it's protected. I feel like, yes, it's protected. Yes, it's going to be modified. Yes, it's opportunity. Yes, the situation will improve. All right, because some of you guys, I'm staring at the Five of Cups here, could have felt like If there was a reconciliation, then obviously there, was a separation at some point in time where somebody felt like, they felt like there was a loss here. Maybe they were disappointed. Maybe they felt like, they're going down the rabbit hole again. My spirit's like, yes, this will improve. Some of you guys could be guided to ask for help from others. All right. Or this person is going to help you in some type of way. Or some of you guys could be asking your friends advice. I'm getting things like that about this situation. Yeah, but you have romance here. All right, but it came out sideways. So it may not be here yet for some of you guys, or some of you guys it could be. But notice you have the bird here and this yes, right? And then you also have the bird at the top of romance right here. And as I look at the back of these cards, they're drawing me to the back. So the back of these cards look like this. And in this deck, it's the same card at the top that says, listen to your intuition. So your intuition could be telling you something, or I'm getting immediately what I was getting is high priestess energy. You guys both could be very intuitive people who are undergoing a transformation in the crown chakra currently at this time. I'm also getting a connection to Isis or Egyptian ancient royalty. You guys could both have the same, like, come from the same, I don't know if this is like bloodline or tribe or whatever this is. It's like twins, like they twins, like twin flames. Like this is somebody who shares the same power soul. I'm getting magician in my third eye, super magic manifestors. This is well. All right. But yes to romance. I'm getting synergy. This is watched, whatever this is watched closely by the divine. And the divine is bringing it together. All right. This is also giving me the two of cups in my third eye as well. Like mutual feelings. There's a choice being made, but if there's a choice being made, there's two yeses here and a huge opportunity with improvement with romance right in the middle of all of this. So this is beautiful. This is if you've been half struggling or feel like your love life was blocked, I feel like some type of something has been unlocked. All right. It could have to do with communication here as well. Communicate clearly. Somebody could have felt like, this was supposed to bring big, happy changes. Maybe there's a separation. Maybe it didn't bring the changes that you or somebody else had hoped for. All right. But I feel like communication, also, I feel like telepathic communication is very big. Like you guys could be able to, telepathically communicate, literally. I mean, this could be songs, this could be downloads, this could be whatever, but I also feel like this is two very expressive beings. The name Munji could be significant. Somebody's name could be Munji. I'm staring at this communication card because I feel like there's more I'm supposed to be looking at. It's like clear communication. Somebody maybe didn't have clear communication. It's like, okay, a part of this opportunity comes with a different level of communication. So you may be how I'm communicating right now, talking. There's going to be a higher level to the way that you guys communicate. I feel like songs, downloads, thinking the same time, what thinking about each other at the same time, whatever this is, it just feels synergy. It feels like a deep connected, connection. I don't know how else to say it, but I also feel like with yes being here, you guys can't see it, so I'll show you. With yes being here and yes being here, it's like this person saying yes, this person saying yes. It's like a mutual choice. And I feel like communication is a part of this opportunity. Like it's very, very strong. Maybe somebody's never had communication like this before. This could very much be somebody's love language. People have acts of service, touch. It's like somebody's one of somebody's huge love languages is words of affirmation, communication. Okay. So what else do we have? Abundance. All right, somebody could have been in a very negative space. They weren't thinking very positively, but remain positive in reverse here, which is blocking this huge, like with romance comes an opportunity and abundance. This ain't just romance, honey. This is, you see the money on here. This is a very wealthy connection. And what I said at the beginning with two, people from the same tribe or Egyptian royalty is what I'm getting here as I'm looking at this deck. I guess I'm about to use this real quick, is This is deep. This is deep. It's not just, it's deeper than the connection. It's going to bring in, I'm hearing a lot of wealth. And this could be material wise. I really think some of it is, but a lot of it is like within yourself, richness within yourself, richness within the connection. All right, somebody could have, rejected somebody at some point in time or rejected this opportunity due to negative thinking. But with the Four of Pentacles, I feel like somebody wants to hold on to you. They want to hold on to you, honey. Out came is the Knot of Cups. This is a wish fulfillment. This is somebody's dream come true. This is a wish fulfillment. Somebody's like, I'm holding on to this romance. I'm holding on to this opportunity. I'm holding on to you with this Four and this Nine, honey. And then the now I'm channeling the Key by Thames. Now I'm getting the song, Fisher the Key to the Kingdom. Is it a key to the kingdom? Something, something. I never leave. All right. Unisprint's like, I'll never leave. Like, you got, we, it's like two people who got the keys to the kingdom unlocking the motherfucking palace. All right. Or building that shit. Whatever this is, it's deep. It's deep. All right. What else do we have here? And then recovery. And then reconsider. So somebody could be reanalyzing, reconsidering this connection. I feel like reconsidering whether to recover this or not. There could be forgiveness here that has to happen here, all right? Because forgiveness is right here. Reconsider forgiveness. So somebody could have had to forgive somebody in this situation as well, which is helping this connection recover. Specifically, crown chakra, heart chakra, and hands. It's like something's being purified, regenerated. Somebody's wiping their hands clean from a situation, being able to forgive. All right. Because maybe somebody felt like something was unlikely at some point in time, but you see the full moon above this. It's a full moon tonight, 12/12, when I said that. It's like some illusion is being has is being beaten. But the with the moon here, that unlikely, I feel like staring straight at this moon 222 as I'm saying this. It's like something was unbalanced. This collaboration kind of come together because something was an illusion. Whether this was an illusion somebody had put over herself, an illusion somebody else is putting over them. Whatever this is made somebody feel like, oh, this is unlikely to recover. Whatever this is, all right. But you have don't stop improving health and listen to your intuition. That's crazy how the card ended up coming out. This is the card I was talking about when it said on the back. There's two people. This is the same. You get it? This is the same thing. Listen to your intuition. This is two people who are listening to their intuition. I feel like high priest, high priestess energy are just two very intuitive, tapped in people. All right. But maybe your intuition was telling you at some point in time that something was unlikely, which is taking me back to where even the unlikely part, there's a full moon right here. The moon card. Maybe the illusion was somebody felt like they couldn't trust something here or whatever this is. Let's keep going. Yeah, but in the near future, there's 92 Barbie. In the near future, something is coming in. So spirit's like, don't stop. I'm also hearing like, or not hearing, I'm also seeing the horn being blown here, as in like judgment. Like somebody is deciding on you. But not only that, the universe has decided on this connection before they even brought this to Earth. Right? This was in the ethereal realm. This was in heavenly. This was before. This was already. Somebody could already be together in the spiritual realm, and it's now coming down to the 3D. The health of this connection, the wealth of this is going to be a healthy, wealthy, abundant connection. All right. And maybe this hasn't came in yet, but in the near future, I'm getting two earth angels here. In the near future, this is coming in. All right. You have helpful people and then no. I feel like some people could be saying no, there's something better than this connection. No. Like there's so many no's, all right. But in the near future, maybe in the next couple of weeks, it's like spirit is saying, like, it's up to you. All right. It's up to you whether you want this connection or not. All right, because I do feel like, maybe there are people around who are saying, no, it's like somebody's better than this person, or this connection is not going to improve. And it's like spirit is wanting you to remember this is your decision. All right. There are some helpful people around, but they're, I'm hearing critics. All right, but I'm getting you're paying attention to the signs, or you're looking for a sign, paying attention to the signs of synchronicities, and ultimately understanding that the choice is yours, whether you want to go through with this or not. Because this does, with the cards that I'm pulling here, especially with that nine of cups and that four, it's like somebody's like, I'll be damned. Yeah, perfect timing, and then let go, and then choosing the direction. So maybe somebody had to let go of something here or someone before this new direction could come in, or before this new person could come in. All right. Or being able to let go, allowed something to come in and within divine timing, or will be. And it's going to allow you to choose this new direction for your life. But I don't see you here by yourself. This kind of looks like, oh my goodness. Don't this look like a portal opening up right here? All right, for this to come together, it's like, I also feel like I'm getting the message of like two people being brought together in divine timing to open up. I don't want to say a portal, like to open up something for the other world. This could be two healers as well, as you see people coming to the altar. I watched Down to Earth a while ago with Zac Efron in it. Where was they at? I want to say they could have been in Paris, Italy. I don't know. One of the episodes here, it was like somebody, they were all walking with lights, right? And they were all coming together, unified to pray and to basically be in this beautiful, healing, abundant energy. So I also feel like this is not, it feels deeper because it's not just about the two right here. These may just be the leaders. But look at all the other people. It's like this connection is going to help heal a lot more than, than what I feel like somebody is seeing, or, because the 3D realm, you can't base everything off of 3D. It's like the spiritual realm got something cooking up. That's why somebody was being guided to reconsider. Because somebody could have said no. Then you have yes. So yes, no, yes, no. All right. Maybe somebody's reconsidering, reanalyzing right now, making a decision. All right. But forgiveness is here right next to yes. Maybe somebody's reconsidering, deciding to forgive in a situation after saying no. But whatever this is, I feel like the choice is yours. The choice is yours. You have free will. And I feel like within this month and the next couple of months, regardless of whatever you choose, it's going to be abundant, because abundance lives within you. The energy that you vibe off of is what you're going to attract. All right. So you're attracting abundance into your life just by walking in the energy of abundance. And spirit is saying, take action. Take off. This is like Knight of Wands energy. Moving very quick, fast pace. All right, remain positive. So I feel like something's gonna come in very quickly, fast paced. As soon as somebody reconsiders something, it's like something moves quickly. All right, and you're gonna get a sign, or you've been getting signs about this. One more card here, and the same card came out again. Communicate. Maybe there's a lack in communication as well, and that's what's being forgiven, and as well as improved within these next couple of weeks and months, or next couple of weeks and months, this month and next month. Okay, so where are we at? 18. So what do we have to sign off here? We split the deck at this could be the one. You've already met the romantic partner you seek. And chemistry, there's a strong magnetic attraction here. So this seems, like I said, you have free will. You know your situation. Take what resonates, leave what doesn't. But this is the read that I'm getting here. This is a past life relationship here, or a person from your past. You have known each other before, but past life relationship, this feels like in another lifetime, you're remembering this person from a past life. That's why the magnetic pull is so strong, because you've been with this person before. As well as codependencies, addictions are affecting romantic love life. Somebody could have people still codependent on their energy, people still in their energy. Addictions could be involved, or it could just be the fact that codependency is like somebody's dependent on you, or somebody's dependent on this other person, and it could be, creating a blockage as well. All right, you have let your friends help you, ask for and accept support from others. All right, so your friends could be, helping you in this situation. With flirt at the bottom of the deck, extend your lighthearted energy to others. I feel like somebody does want not only to extend this beautiful energy, but they also want to extend this connection because it's like a connection from a past life coming into this life. It's like the extension between worlds, if that makes sense. It's kind of like jacking my brain up. You know what I'm saying? So spirit wants you to stay optimistic because something you haven't, it's like you haven't met somebody. Yes, you're reconciling with somebody. So even if you haven't met this person yet, it's like you're not meeting them. You remember them. You remember their essence. You remember their energy. All right. But spirit also doesn't want you to forget about yourself. Love yourself first. Your self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. So the way that you love yourself, value yourself, know your worth is also what this person is attracted to. It's also what they remember within themselves as well as you. Reconciliation at the bottom of the deck. Someone from your past is returning to your life. Freaking beautiful. This is also giving me like the Titanic vibes. Like when they're on the boat. Let me stop. All right, and then you have true love. Make the effort. All right, why? Because here's Cupid. You deserve love. All right. Somebody could have been wearing a false mask in this relationship at some point in time. There could have been some deception. All right. Unrequited love. Maybe somebody felt like at some point in time there wasn't enough attraction or chemistry here. But right after that, you have enjoyed the bliss of holiday time together. Didn't I say Sagittarius season, December? So around Christmas, maybe you guys by that time are going to be spending the holidays together. Whatever. This seemed beautiful. All right. But like I said, there was a situation where somebody could have been deceptive when it came to feelings, attraction, chemistry, or to, really wanting to make the effort here. So I feel like that's what's going on right now in your situation. I'm also getting, you have free will, but this does feel very, 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 very deep, like on a whole nother scale, dimension. If you guys are touching different dimensions together, 222, as I said that. All right. And then you have give your relationship a chance, work on your partnership. All right. So that's what I have for you guys. Like, comment, subscribe, share, and come back for your next read. All right. All right. All right. Peace.